Topic 2, Lesson 4, Writing Rules for Situations. Well, you've already learned how to find number pairs that fit a pattern and a rule. In this lesson, you're going to learn how to find a rule for a table that already has some pairs of numbers on it. Our standard is to generate a number or shape pattern, in this case a number pattern, that follows a given rule. Our focus is what is the math rule for this situation. Let's take a look at an example. Here we have two people. We have Nelson and his age, and then we have Pam and her age. And the question is, what rule can you find from this table? Well, let's take a look. If we start with Nelson's age, and we go find out what Pam's age is too, what happens there? Well, it looks like we go 4 minus 2, and we get 2. That seems simple, but let's see if that rule applies all the way across. Same with 10. If Nelson is 10, we subtract 2. Yes, we get 8. So the rule works. Let's try it one more time. 8 minus 2. Do we get 6? Yes. So the rule works. Let's continue. Let's say Nelson is 11. If we subtract 2, then Pam's age should be 9. And if we try, let's say Nelson is 7, subtract 2, then Pam's age is 5. So what is the rule? We're going to subtract 2 from Nelson's age every single time. So no matter how old Nelson gets, you subtract 2, you're going to get Pam's age. That is the rule, subtract 2. Let's take a look at another example here. And I want you to take a look at this table, then stop the video and try it on your own. So let's say you have a number machine, and the number machine, what goes in, something else comes out. So this is the in, and you get your numbers, and something comes out. See if you can find the rule. So pause the video now, and good luck. All right, how did you do? Let's take a look. Well, if we look at the rule here, we go from 2 and we get 6. Well, what did we do? Well, we could add by 4, and we do get 6, but does that really help us out? Is that really the rule? It could be. We don't have the other numbers here, or here, or here, but we have one here. Now, if I go from 10 to 30, if I add 4, is that going to get me 30? No. So adding 4 is not the rule. What else could we do? Well, let's take a look at another one. Let's say we have 2 times 3. Yes, that gets us 6. And let's go over here to the 10. If I multiply by 3, 10 times 3, do I get 30? Yes. So maybe the rule is that we're going to multiply by 3. So let's do that. 9 times 3, we're going to get 27. And we'll skip this one and go to this one. 8 times 3, we're going to get 24. But this one here is a little different. We know we can multiply by 3, but we don't have this top number. So we're going to have to try something a little different. So in this case, we can actually go the opposite way and go, all right, 15 divided by 3 will get us a number, or we could look at it this way. Something times 3 equals 15. Well, if you know your multiplication facts, you're going to know that it's 5. So the rule is multiply by 3. All right, now try some on your own. Good luck.